As of currently, the bricks are 36 pixels tall across the two sets, right? So that's 36 pixels. If I'm going to animate this, I need to have the animation be 36 frames long, because they're going to move down one pixel per frame as you run up. That's the speed that Armand is moving at, is one pixel per animation frame. So, right now I've got my 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 bricks here. I need to duplicate this a bunch of times. But first, it will be a lot easier actually if I make them descend as they are. So let me just see what I can get away with here. And I actually should be making sure that they animate nice and smoothly first. I'm doing a little trick, okay? So, it looks like these were all made to respect each other, right? But actually they don't. This line here, right, does not connect with this line here, right? But because those lines don't actually, you don't get to see that continuity. You just get the effect of the perspective. But I bet you I could copy and paste this up again up here and you won't even notice. So to make this descend the way it needs to, what I'm going to do is take, literally just start pulling it down. So it's going to be like the first one is nothing. The second one is one. Third one is one, two. One, two, three. You can see what I'm doing here. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And I can just check that. Yep. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay, so now they're moving down. And you can see they move down with the bricks. Arkin Pixel says, why are you doing this to yourself? Oh, because it's fun. Okay, now you're probably saying, okay, but now you have to do that for the full rotation, right? There's 36 pixels we've got to move down. So how are you going to do that? Well, I think that I can take this 56, add 36 to it. So that gives us 92. So now I take my bricks, I copy them, I paste them, and I move them down like 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Perfect. Look at that. Oh, geniuses. And we're going to do the same thing, but this time 18. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Look at that. Now, this is the genius part. Now we can copy this, right? And move this one up until it sits right here. And I can do it again as well. Look at that. So that's a loop. So ignoring the snapping right now, what you want to look at is if you can trace one down, that's what you want to do. How are you going to make it loop smoothly? The goal, so, okay. Let me draw you one frame of what I'm thinking of. We're either going to draw the cracks, right? Like this, and animate this, right? And the bricks fade in and out through this column of light, just in the middle. So that's one way we could do it. And we don't have to even do all of them. We can actually have them playing in it. We can have them like sort of coming in and out of the light. Or we can bring a color up and draw them sitting on top, but then shade them. Right, so you'd see like this and this. And I would do, like I said, I would do patches. I wouldn't do all of them on every brick everywhere. I would do something like this, right? So I would do something like this, and then I would go like this. You see? And I would animate those four bricks passing through. And I would do like five or six of those. Now keep in mind, I have to animate like 40 frames of this. So it's maybe not the best idea, but... I would animate maybe one or two of these full animations of a set of rocks like this, rotating down. That's what I would do. And I would dot them around. I'd put like maybe one up here, one down here, and put them at different phases so that one starts, you know, down the bottom left, one starts in the top middle, one starts sort of halfway up the top, or more towards the top, you know, a little bit to the left, and then the very top one's sort of more to the right. And I would animate those going round and round. And I would then compress them down onto one 40 frame animation. And then you would get the impression of, yeah, lots of different rocks everywhere. Now, I wonder, like, if I put this up here, if that would give you the same effect. I think it will. I don't think it's too bad. So this period here of me playing around with this is really for, like, style and experimentation. You know, if it's going to take me 40 frames, I need to know, like, what I'm doing so that I can just go on autopilot and get it done. Otherwise, I'll be sitting here for quite some time. And if I don't have the style right at a place that I'm comfortable with, changing it is going to be even more time. So I'm sort of just taking the time to... This is like a test, really. This is just like me testing the thing. So the whole palette thing, I mean, it's, you know, it's just about consistency. And it's not... There's no clear value that you get out of being that consistent. But there is, I think, a hidden... something, you know, just like a, it's like a layer of authenticity that you create, that if you didn't have it, you wouldn't notice. But if you, when you do have it, it's like, oh yeah, yeah, you know what I mean? These need to be equidistant. 20. 22. Really? Wait, from here to here should be the same amount. That's 21. That's 22, so I'll drop this down one. I feel like these lines are going to really reinforce something that I don't want to do, and I don't know how to fix it. I'm sort of like running away from a reality that I'm about to be facing, which is the fact that I don't have any vertical perspective. You know, I'll just put up with it like this. Now, we merge this down. We change all the colors to the darker color. Hey. I would love to be able to... Can I replace a color with nothing? I think I can do that. Let's try something for a second. I grab all of this, right? All of this. And I go to change a selection. Oh my god, that is so powerful. Does that go every frame? Oh my god, that is so powerful. Wow. That is awesome. Take all of this. Within this selection, I'm going to change the color. Actually, let's go... inverse it outside of the selection. I'm going to change the color of all of these bricks to be the darkest shade. That saved me a lot of time. Do we want to just see this in the game? Just to see? That's Pog. I guess we did just animate every brick. Wow. Wow. All right, now it's time to actually do this again, but with... That was a great test. We are animating some bricks here at the moment. Trust me, they're gonna look awesome when they're done. Can I shade this in a way that won't take me forever? I won't have a crack at this stage. I can't do it. Because the crack will be on every single brick. They're all the same brick, that's the problem. But I could at least have even shading. Like, I could do something like this. You get a little bit of depth. You get a little bit of lighting. I can make this darker. This will basically go to this color here. So I just have to do that 9 times. Expand by 1. Press M, delete. Take this, move it up by 1, select it all, select contract by 1, move it down, press enter, delete. Merge down, one more time. First of all though, I will move these so that they're at the top or like half off maybe. Okay. Merge it down. Now here's where we get the shading done. The shading in the tower, you can offer the suggestion, but I won't read it for a little bit, is because the shading from the top of the tower is static, right? So now what I do is I take all of these frames, right? And over all of these frames, I wanna control select. So I want this color, right? And across all of this, I'm going to replace, let's invert that with the darker color. Okay, but that didn't quite do what we wanted to do because we needed to select it across all the frames. And now the shading applies. Holy moly. That's a lot of bricks. Oh shit. That looks 3D. Yeah, the under the side of the stairs is really obvious. I was thinking I could have posts coming holding the stairs up. All right, so the question is, how frequently do I want these to show up? Let's put 1 and we'll just draw it freehand and we'll see what we like, just based on what looks good. Thick ones that appear infrequently. Yeah, that sounds about right to me. Now, we could do different designs here. We could make them like... No. No, 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 no. Not different designs. These are functional. We could do them every like 90 degrees. Okay, so... I need to somehow animate this. I think that's generally... These could be considered the same size. Basically, wherever the shadow is. If you imagine that running up, it's almost at the bottom of the shadow. That's a lot of frames to get from there to there smoothly. So the halfway point is 11. And what should we call the halfway? Like here? Would you say that's halfway? How many steps rotate between here and the end? It's like 6, right? Well, it should be 6 because it's 42. Yeah, it's exactly 6. So we count 3 steps. 1, 2, 3. And then pull that to the wall. Come down, wherever that is. Okay, so at the 11th frame, we should be seeing this. So many people playing Cadence of Hyrule. Is that out already? Did I miss something? How have I failed so hard at this? It's as if you've never done this before. It is as if I've never done this before. You are totally right. You know, what I should be doing is really just following the guides. I should have separated these into like long and short. Like that's long. That's long. And then the middle between these was this. And the middle between this was... No, the 45 degree point was here. That's right. I'm silly. I'm so confused. So it would be a good idea now to try to do the same thing on the edges. I guess I would just draw this line here. I would just run out along this line here and do the same thing. So I guess like 50% would be, we'll call this point here. So we'll take this white and we'll go 1, 2. And then halfway is, well, we've got the steps to guide us actually, but just layer number 47. Well, I've deleted a lot of layers since then, so don't be too worried about it. Okay, I think that's pretty good. Distribution wise, maybe this one could be a little closer and this one could be a little closer to that. That's probably right. Okay. That looks left of center. The reason why it looks left of center is because of this cutting off. You really have to think about, look at these two walls here. That's what'll do it for you. If you look at this point and put it between these two walls, that's center. But if you think about the staircase, it looks like it's too far to the left. You bought your son Super Smash Brothers today? Nice. That's awesome. May he be the next Mango. There we go. There are a lot of frames to it. It's a big loop. It's a lot of work. But I'm really happy with it so far. You ready? Here it comes. Oh. I'm going to hold right and I'm going to answer Viv's question. Okay, Viv, I've been doing gameplay for... I've been doing game development probably since 2010, but I haven't actually released anything ever. So I'm sort of more just, I'm just a hobbyist really. This will be the first game that I've actually published or like produced that I would release. Yeah, that's the top. So I've got a floor on it. When we come up through here, we should end up over here. Perfect. And then as it rotates around, now obviously everything's not ready yet, but I also got a roof. Now this will have to be kind of like rotating as well, I suppose, as we come up to here. But that's how you move through it. This door will look like, right now it's just a big yellow square, but it'll look like some broken rocks. And that's gonna also sort of come around in 3D. Watchtower outside. Query West, thank you so much for the host, buddy. You can see this is made up of 1, 2, 3, 4 bricks here. And I've basically just like got some bricks are half bricks and some bricks are full bricks that have been erased. So it's more or less this layer here, but sort of, you know, cut out. So I suppose what I'll do is the top of the door will have to be flat then. Yeah, it's gonna have to have no perspective to it. Damn it. All right. Oh well. I'll just start working on it like this. You know, you have these plans and sometimes they just don't work. This is what I love about you. You aren't afraid to change course, even if it means a good amount of rework. I mean, I just don't have any other option at this point. It's kind of like, well, I gotta do it this way or I don't do it at all. I'm in too deep, brother. You know, no one's gonna be like, oh, that scene in the beginning of this chapter was really cool, but you know, it doesn't matter that the rest of the game was crappy. What are we looking at here? Oh, I'm in too deep. My hair instead of going under. God, I don't think that's good. It's not going to be rotating all the way up the thing. I don't have to do that. It only this from here down to here is all I need. Just 180 degrees worth of turning. Yeah, this door is at the bottom of the tower. Did you finish the cave pick yet? That needs to hit Reddit and or Twitter. I mean, the cave is now sort of in the game, but I haven't gone back and finished the pick. You can see them here. I don't know if we got exactly where we wanted to out of it, but you know, it's okay. It's been a little while. I'm sort of a bit like curious to see if I can finish it off. Probably this week. I actually had plans to work on it today. Instead of this, but I thought, you know what? I want to work on this instead. Godot, if you want something, if you want to learn something new and maybe a little challenging, Godot. Godot. I just don't know, like, a lot of people are like, oh, Godot's so good, but it's like, I haven't seen how good it is. I can't guarantee the support is there. Construct, I've heard good things about Construct, but a game that I was following for a long time that was built in Construct, the developer moved away from Construct as he was making the game, so I don't know what that says about it. So I have to make this start and end at a specific point, which is the tough part. Because it doesn't make sense anywhere else. So I kind of want it to start... actually, you know what? No, it should be just... I should be able to just place it where I want it to be.
Window maker.
That's me. Even lower, wow. It's not a very tall door. How did I manage to make it so short? All right, are we happy to move on from this now? So what I would do, if I was animating this for realsies, which I am, is I would consider putting this background in the scene. So like imagine this with the parallax. How would you even animate mountains? I wouldn't. I would just have the mountains rotate really fast around. See, like that? major value add, do you think so? No, we can, the thing is, we can loop it. You don't know. You don't know, my dude. Like this. You know what? We just need two of them. You're right. We don't even need the infinite scroll. We just need the parallax. Copy it, paste it over here, and then flip this one, and then do like basically that. Done. Easy. Mind the seam. Damn. Okay. What now? You guys like it? Okay. All right. I thought it was a little much, but that's cool. So what I would then do is I would have this, maybe for now, we'll just make it a little transparent. So you can see just a bit of the outside. Yeah, I'll darken it for sure. And then what I could do is remove, like have this be a mask. Let's do it right now. On late update, we're going to say animator.spriteRenderer.sprite. We're going to say mask.sprite equals done. I got the bricks, they are on background zero. And then there should be a mask interaction, visible outside mask. Same with the lights. Now, what is gonna happen? Now, it's not perfect because we didn't get the sides of the thing in. But we're close. Let me show you guys the tower as it stands currently. So I've been doing some masking. Check this out, right? So as we go to the top here, look, the tower actually gets masked out. So technically there's actually still a tower here, right? Above this, but there's a mask that I've got that's cutting it off, which makes it look like the tower actually stops at a given spot. I'm just in the process of doing something similar with this door right in the middle here. So remember before, we actually had bricks here, right? On the inside of this wall. But because we set this all to be one big mask, they got removed. So instead, what I'm doing is I'm going to create a mask of the empty space and leave the bricks in as a separate sprite. Oh, we got something. That looks like bricks. They're not perfectly aligned, but we got something. Hey, first try. Okay, so that works. Now we just gotta think of a color that we want this to be. So, did you like the video? Thank you so much for watching. I wanted to say a really considerate and heartfelt thank you to the patrons of the stream and of my YouTube channel. Thank you to Joe Constant, to Jacob, Gerald, Jim Kulwicki, to Raimu, to Robin Fritz, Alex, Jaded Cat, and Jared Barboza. You guys help this train keep going, so thank you mostly. For those of you who want to join that list of J names, there's like what, 2-3 names that don't start with J in that list. If you want to offset the balance and restore peace to the world, join me on Patreon, become a patron. Otherwise, come to Twitch and subscribe. Links for that are all below. Have a lovely day, and I'll catch you on the next video.